Pat, you got all that.
Oh.
Yeah, that's not good.
Yeah.
So, what exactly went wrong? Well, let's go over the parts of a Babbitt bear, and I'll show you how they're poured. Now this lighter silver material in the middle is our actual Babbitt material. Now Babbitt is made of around 80 to 85% tin with the rest in even parts of antimony and copper. Now what happens is this bearing will sit on top of the shaft like so, and it's going to make direct contact with the steel shaft. On the top here we have an oil hole, and inside the bearing is a little grease groove for that oil to spread out over the shaft. Now, as this makes direct contact with the shaft, it'll wear down. Now, as I mentioned, there's antimony and copper in the Babbitt, and those are going to be a much harder crystal than the tin. So what happens is, as this shaft is rotating, it's wearing down the tin, but the antimony and copper, being harder, stay behind. So microscopically, on the surface of these bearings, there are little channels getting worn in to where this oil will slick across this whole bearing. Now through this grease groove, that oil is going to come in and it's going to spread on the shaft, and that's going to spread to the rest of the bearing. Now Babbitt bearings are especially good for stuff just like this, where there's high speed and impact. They hold up really, really well to impact because of that hydroscopic layer of oil that is created when that tin gets worn down. So basically there's a barrier of oil between the shaft and the bearing itself at all times, provided the bearing is working correctly. In addition, so long as they're given constant lubrication, they will hold up for quite a long time. There's no rollers to replace, there's no balls to replace. If the bearing cracks or fails, it's not some screaming mess like you would have with a ball bearing where suddenly pulley seize and stuff just stops and breaks. Now how long do Babbitt bearings last? Well, they can last for a very long amount of time. As you can see here, there's a little bit of a gap, and what you can do is you can put a series of shims in here to take out as that bearing wears down. Eventually, the copper and the antimony are going to wear down to where there's a little bit of play between the shaft and the bearing. And it's at that point you want to take out a couple of those shims and drop the bearing down, and then you're good to go. Once these two blocks get to touching, you probably need to re-pour your bearings, but that'll be many, many years down the road. So now let's take a look at these bottom bearings, and then we're going to go over how these are poured. So here we've got the shaft removed from our bearings. Now recently on YouTube, Ian O'Halloran asked, how exactly do you pour these? I mean, how do you make a mold to get this perfect shaped bearing in here? Well, actually, you use the shaft as a mold. So what you do is you take this neat compound called Babbitt and basically roll it into, we'll just say a cylinder, how about, and set it around the bearing just like that, you know, with the shaft in place and everything, and you squeeze it close to where it'll seal it up, and then you do the same on this side and you pour your metal. Now what went wrong in the first part of this video is I had preheated these blocks a little too much, so this Babbitt didn't exactly stick to there. It was so hot that it kind of just oozed off, and when that hot metal hit it, it just blew out and there went my bearing. So, in order to get the right thickness of bearing though, you have to put a spacer for the shaft to rest on. And here's that spacer. It's just a piece of 1/4 inch aluminum that I put at the bottom that shaft could rest on to give us this proper thickness of our bearing right here. Now the reason why I used aluminum is because it's softer than steel and it's not going to mar the shaft at all. So that way, that gave us, you know, about 1/4 inch to maybe 5/16 thick bearing on the bottom. Well, That's all for today. Ian, I hope this answered your question. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, etc., leave them in the comments down below. If you are not subscribed already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Check us out, ironwolfindustrial.com. Follow us on Instagram. And if you have any questions you don't want to leave in the comments or whatever, shoot me an email, ironwolfindustrial@gmail.com. And as always, thanks for watching. Work hard and stay humble.